Hey there, Sabre TV, Miranda Mason here, just outside the Dell basketball courts where the Ball with the Hoos events with the basketball team is taking place, which we'll talk about in just a few minutes. But today I'm coming at you for a very special reason because it's our very first episode of a new show we're working on for Thursdays. Every Thursday, you're going to have a chance to take a look inside UVA Athletics. I'm going to bring you interviews, headlines, and what's up with UVA Athletics that week. However, we haven't come up with a name for it yet, which you've already helped us start. This past week, you've been putting name or potential names on the message boards, and of those names, I picked my top five favorites. We're going to put those in a poll on the website for you to vote for, so you get to name this show. One of the biggest headlines surrounding Virginia athletics this week is the quarterback situation for Virginia football. Phillip Sims came in as a transfer student and a transfer quarterback from Alabama this past summer and has had a couple of opportunities to find some game time play this season. His biggest showing was against Louisiana Tech last week where he came in, the team was down by 20 points and he almost came back to win the game from a deficit. In the post-game press conference, Mike London was reluctant to talk about who would be his starting quarterback this week against Duke because he said he had to go back and look at the film and make a call as to what the game situations were and why things went wrong. On Monday in the press conference, he was also, again, not so keen to mention who his starting quarterback would be, and the depth chart showed the same sort of mentality. Michael Rocco and Phillip Sims were listed as or quarterbacks, meaning that either one of them could start and a decision hadn't been made. However, in the radio show that same night, Mike London mentioned that Phillip Sims had suffered an injury during Louisiana Tech, and if he was recovered in time for Duke, he would be the starting quarterback for Virginia. Since then, it seems Sims has healed really well, and he will start this Saturday at Duke for the first time since high school for the University of Virginia Cavaliers. So it's official, Phillip Sims is getting the start this Saturday against Duke. What's the student reaction to it?
Well, I think that Rocco has had his chance. I think he's a good quarterback. I just think that Phillip Sims has proved himself in the past few games. He's coming in the fourth quarter. I think he hasn't thrown an interception. He has like six touchdowns. So I think that he deserved it and that he won the job.
I think that it's going to be really good for us. Hopefully there's going to be a change. It's going to be an aggressive offense for us. And we're excited to see him start.
Well, I hope he's as good as Rocco in terms of like the first two quarters usually. But as long as he doesn't throw as many interceptions, I'll be just as happy.
Personally, I think that this is a good idea for Virginia football's future. Phillip Sims has an incredible arm. He was a highly sought after recruit out of high school. And Michael Rocco is a good game manager and a good team leader, but there's no arguing that Phillip Sims just has the better arm, and he's demonstrated that he can get the job done. Another fun event going on in UVA Athletics this week is actually what's going on behind me here at the Dell basketball courts. It's the Ball with the Hoos event that the basketball team is putting on. It gives students a chance to actually go out on the courts and play basketball with the basketball team. They can play knockout, a little bit of hot shot, as well as have a three-point contest. There's free pizza, free prizes from Hoo Crew. We're about to go down there, check out what the students have to say about it, as well as maybe talk to a couple of players.
Today is Ball with the Hoos. It was a good event that we put together to get the students to interact a little bit with the basketball team. Even though we don't do like a Midnight Madness type thing that most colleges do, we wanted to make sure we can do something to get students ready to come out and cheer for us this year. So this event's been great, and everybody's out here having a good time.
You found anybody that you could recruit yet?
Kelly. Kelly, who's hit 10 three-pointers and set a record out here. She just had a baby, and she's setting records, so she's balling. She's definitely balling.
Can you talk about a little bit of the student support that you've had today?
Oh, it's been great. We expected way less, but we got way more than, of course, what we expected. The students came out with a lot of positive energy, came out with their basketball shoes on, ready to go, and it just feels good as a player to, you know, see that the student body has your back and they're willing to go and have fun with you, but also cheer for you when you're going in big games.
In other UVA athletics news, there's a big women's soccer game at home as well as a field hockey game that all of you, if you have the chance, should go out and check out. I'll be heading to Duke this Saturday to go see the football game, watch Phillip Sims get his first start, see how it goes and what the outcome is. Otherwise, I really want the show to be really interactive so that you guys have a chance to give me an idea of what you want me to talk about each week. Tweet me, tweet the Sabre. My Twitter name is @MirandaLee, Miranda_Lee with three A's. just tell me what you want me to talk about so that you guys have a chance to be a part of this show and tell me what it is that's important to you as far as UVA athletics goes. And don't forget to vote for the winning name so that the show has a name next week that I can tell you what the winner is. And for now, for Sabre TV, I'm Miranda Mason.